This is the Reality Radio Network on Telstar 5 Transponder 5 and on the internet at realityradionetwork.com.
Folks, welcome to the show. I'm Sherry Schreiner. Tonight's going to be a listener call-in. You can give me a call at 260-356-2611. That's 260-356-2611. This week I'm going to go over a few things the Lord has led me into. I've heard from people formerly leaders and directors of different areas, different groups within the New Age movement, and they're floored. You know, they're floored how I can hit it on the head with the information I have in regards to that movement. And folks, it's just the things the Lord leads me to expose, to reveal, to teach. There's nothing hidden in the darkness that won't be brought to the light. And He's bringing all the wickedness and evil of these agendas to light. You know, at the same time, when we see people involved with the New Age finally see it for what it is and get out, we see professing believers cross over and go to their side. So who wasn't going to be deceived in the last day, folks? You know, many are. Many of you are going to be. And that's why I spend so much time warning on this show, to strengthen your spirits in the Lord, build a close relationship with Him, so you won't be led astray. You know, so many people get caught up in the one scripture from Paul that states that people won't be deceived, that if it were possible, even the elect would be deceived or wouldn't be deceived. And the elect isn't deceived. They're not deceived now. You know, they're not going to be deceived later. And the problem is the elect is a very, very small group, 144,000 out of all the millions of believers on this planet. So that means a lot of millions of people are very susceptible to being deceived. And that's why I spend so much time on this. If they're not going to be deceived in the future, then they wouldn't be deceived now. And how many are sitting in doctrines, in churches from hell, preaching doctrines of demons? They're supporting these beasts, these wolves. They're in errors now. They're sending them their money, their tithes, weekly, monthly, making these beast prophets wealthy beyond imagination, millionaires, and all the while claiming they're not deceived. And so, folks, we have a problem now with deception in the church. It's going to get much worse later, much worse. And the true minority of believers is going to be a handful. Because your main church stream, your main people, and all of these churches are going to be the ones that come against and persecute the Lord's true believers. You know, I've said it before, a lot of these beast prophets are in place to lead church people astray, to lead the believers astray into accepting the coming deceptions. They're not there to protect you from them. They're there to lead you into them. And you see it with Pat Robertson, how he goes on and on about the Vera chip and how it's not the one in regards to Revelation 13. And right now the Vera chip isn't, but it will be. I mean, there's one that will be, could be, and probably will be. And anything on or in your right hand or forehead, you just stay away from. You stay away from it. But He's conditioning people now. I mean, why would you get it now? It's just as evil now. It may, you know, it won't be as damning as later. But these chips that they're putting in people now are tracking devices, and they've upped them up. I mean, we know for years, and people have experienced this, UFO abductions, military abductions, disguised as UFO abductions. There's both kinds going on, folks. And what they do is they've been implanting tracking chips off people's noses or in their brains, various parts of their body. These are tracking chips. The aliens are not omnipotent. They're not omniscient. They can't be everywhere at once. Their whole kingdom is designed by high-tech and track and control. And so what they do is they chip everybody when they're born. And I've said it before how children, many children wake up with many bloody noses. And there's no explanation for this, you know. And you've probably had them growing up yourself. You just wake up in the middle of the night, you got bloody nose, you don't understand. Most people don't have to be abducted into a UFO to be chipped. You can be chipped right in your sleep. Okay, they can come into your room and they can chip you. And I'm telling you, most of the population is chipped. And these are just tracking devices. And the ones that are coming out now, folks, are like little two-way transistors. And if, you know, being two-way, being that they can not only track you and hear and see the things you're doing, you can hear them too. If you're susceptible to the other realm, some people aren't even, they'll just hear things they can't explain. I had an email from a listener last week stating that when he listens to my show, oftentimes in his left ear, he can hear echoes of a radio station playing, different music. And I've heard that same thing, and it's a military base somewhere, folks. And you can deactivate these chips that they put in you now, these tracking chips. You can deactivate them with neodyme magnets. And I have this information on my website, thewatcherfiles.com, how to detect chips. I have a search box there. Just put in detect chips, and you'll get to my article. And I'll tell you about these neodyme magnets and where to buy them. You can buy them right online. They're only 70 cents a piece. And these things are strong enough to lift 10 pounds of steel. And you can put them on your earlobes with Band-Aids or tape, hold them in place for about 12 hours. Any kind of booster shots, any vaccines that you've had, any flu shots, put a magnet on your arms, the place where they've given you these shots, the closest place that you can remember where they went, and leave those on. Depending, some of you might have to leave them on for 2 days. These booster shots you got when you were kids, some of these shots you got when we were much younger, might have to stay on there for 2 days to deactivate the chips. But these neodyme magnets will deactivate these tracking chips. But these ones coming, that Revelation 13 speaks of, these will damn your soul. And because these are a sign of loyalty, of worship to the Antichrist and his kingdom. I don't know if he's going to come out and say, oh, get this market and show your loyal worship to me. I mean, I think it's going to be more deceptive than that. It very well could be. He could be very bold and brave. You know, I can't say it's not. But anything that goes in around your right hand or forehead, and any guys, they try to deceive you into getting it, don't get it, because what they're going to, they have so much stuff coming. I mean, they've got this whole Crystal City fraud, the New Jerusalem thing they're going to pull off. You want a tour, then you have to join the kingdom of God on earth, and of course, God being this the Antichrist, this, you know, masquerading as God, and his padre, the false prophet. They're going to be encouraging people to join God's kingdom on earth. And, of course, all those who don't are going to be seen as rebels and targets. You're going to become targets of all of those who have joined the kingdom. And so it's going to be a civil war type thing. And they've showed this kind of thing somewhat in Bible prophecy movies that you've seen based on the last days. I don't know if you've seen any of those movies. The Beast Network puts out Megiddo or any of those. And they basically give you an idea. And, you know, not a lot of the stuff they show is wrong. They will give you a lot of truth. They just mix in enough error to lead you going the wrong way. You know, the biggest problem with a lot of these beast networks is that they get people further and further involved and delved into the fake pre-trib rapture theory. So Christians never think they're going to be here. They're not going to be here to see all this stuff happening. And then there's a reality check. It's like all of a sudden they start seeing things happening and they're thinking, well, it can't get any worse because God's going to come back for us. And they're not prepared. They're not ready. And they're going to be ripe for persecution. They're going to be the first ones hounded up and falling to go into these FEMA camps. And of course, if you've been listening to this show long enough, you know that these FEMA camps, you're never going to come back out of them alive once you're in them. Once martial law hits this country, folks, and you get in one of these camps, you're not coming back out.